Prime Minister, Dr. Miller.
Mr. Speaker, today, South Africa belongs to us. We shall be introducing legislation to implement our policy, which we call apartheid, the separation between the races. Races will live and travel separately. Education will be separate for all groups at all levels. Native reserves will become black homelands. Work fitting for the white man will be reserved for him and him alone.
People, move them back to the front!
Apartheid rests on three unarguable foundations. Afrikaner experience, our experience, scientific proof that the white man is a superior being, and biblical witness. Apartheid represents divine will.
Mon.
I'm sorry to disturb you. My name is Mandela. I'm from the African National Congress.
Hi, asibafuna abantu be Congress.
Don't be frightened. I'm a friend. My name is Mandela. I'm from the African National Congress.
Please, come in.
We're calling it the Defiance Campaign. We want volunteers. I'm the National Volunteer in Chief, which just means I'm helping to organize. I'm asking for volunteers for the first wave of protesters. We will call them Armadela Kufa, which means those who are prepared to make sacrifices, those who are prepared to die. We need people who think they can put up with being kicked and beaten and who won't be provoked by violent action. I know I'm asking a lot.
Sir, I can't promise I won't hit back.
You mustn't hit back. Never. Wait for the violence to come from them. I promise you, you won't have to wait long.
I'd like to volunteer, but I've been arrested twice. The second time was for hitting back. I kicked this policeman. Sir, you know I have a very bad temper.
So have I. But I'm learning to control it. If you volunteer, you must learn to control your temper too. These are the rules. You have to remain non-violent no matter what the provocation. You have to dress neatly and cleanly, and there must be no drunkenness.
Go away! Go back to the city! I have two sons in prison in Devon under the pass law. You want me to go to prison too? You want them to arrest everyone? They are an army, and they will kill us. You are saying, let yourself be killed.
No, you're wrong. Let me tell you something. These past few weeks, I've been traveling from one end of the country to the other. And this is what I've learned. We are the army. I swear to you, this is the truth. Everywhere, it's as if we're waking from sleep and understood that no one is alone anymore. Yes, they have guns, but it has nothing to do with guns. Throughout history, no physical might has ever crushed the invincible spirit of a nation. And yes, we are a nation. We must pledge ourselves to liberate South Africa, black, white, and yellow.
My boy, my boy, my boy, Africa. My boy, my boy, my boy.
The figures here, Minister.
Yeah. Shut the window, please. The noise is disturbing.
They're very rough and based largely on ANC claims.
These concern directly this defiance campaign.
They called for 10,000 volunteers. They reckon a little over 8,500 responded. But here's the worrying figure. It's estimated that because of the defiance campaign, membership of the ANC has risen from 7,000 to 100,000, and the campaign is still going on.
Now you understand why I need these wider powers. What I want is more of a catch-all clause. To this effect, I should be able to name anyone I consider a communist a communist.
We'd still have to define communist.
Okay, but in the present draft, it just says only members of the Communist Party are communists. And I want to go further.
I agree. And this is the sort of thing the West understands, especially the Americans. They know the Reds are the common enemy.
Have you a specific suggestion, Minister?
Yeah. I want included in the definition of communist any person or doctrine which aims to bring about political, industrial, social, or economic change, etc., etc. Those persons or doctrines I should be able to name as communists.
Well, perhaps this is the moment, Minister, to bring to your attention our latest police intelligence report. It seems they're planning something they call the Congress of the People at Cliptown, all racial groups, and they're going to read this charter. The Freedom Charter, they call it. If that isn't communism, I want to know what is.
There's only one thing for it. Cut off the head of the snake.
Which gives us a hell of a lot of latitude. Now, this so-called Congress of the People is, of course, a communist conspiracy. And the new laws are designed in part to help us stop it from taking place. Okay. The minister's instructions are that we go for the leaders. So each of you will have a special responsibility. Sergeant Van Niekerk, you get the biggie. Chief Albert Luthuli, president of the ANC. Sergeant Nordi, you're going to look after Walter Sisulu. Now this chap is a real troublemaker. Been with the ANC for years. Now he's General Secretary and he's dangerous. Bloody dangerous. Sergeant Lowe, you take special responsibility for Oliver Tambo. Now this man Tambo, he's an attorney at law and he's a member of the ANC's National Executive Committee. He's been in politics since he was a student and he's clever. So you just watch him closely. Sergeant Swanepoel, you're going to get Nelson Mandela, recruited to the ANC by Walter Sisulu. He's also an attorney and that fellow Tambo's law partner. They've been friends since student days. He's a cheeky bugger, and he's just been elected president of the Transvaal ANC.
The fact is, the Defiance campaign has been a resounding success. I give you my solemn word, we will continue to resist these inhuman laws until every one of them is repealed. Your leaders will continue to fight. Let them arrest us. We cannot be defeated. You all know that song. Open your prison doors. We want to enter. We volunteers. We want to enter. We want to show them up for what they really are. Inhuman, violent men who are frightened of the future. Because the future is ours. The present is simply a price we have to pay. A high price, I grant you, in police sales all over the country. Thousands of us. And of course there's going to be no official inquiry into police brutality. That was to be expected. So we have to go on suffering and...
been found guilty of statutory communism. It has nothing to do with communism as it is commonly known. But I accept the evidence that you have consistently advised your followers to maintain a peaceful course of action and to avoid violence in any shape or form. I am sentencing you to 9 months imprisonment with hard labor, but suspended for 2 years on condition you do not repeat the offense. You may stand down.
Nelson Mandela, Walter Sisulu, and Oliver Tambo. I am authorized under the Suppression of Communism Act No. 44 of 1950 to issue you with a standing order signed by the Minister of Justice. I am going to tell you the main provision of this order.
Thank you, officer, but we can read.
You are hereby confined to the Magisterial District of Johannesburg. No gatherings, no meetings. You can forget the Freedom Charter, boys. You won't be going to Cliptown.
my opinion, Walter, 26 June 1955 will go down in history. There were 3,000 people, African, Indian, colored, and white. We carried banners like freedom in our lifetime and long live the struggle. The Freedom Charter was read in English, Sesotho, and Xhosa. When the speaker said, South Africa belongs to all who live in it, black and white, the people shall govern, there was a great cry of Africa, Maibuye! And so it continued after each section. All shall be equal before the law, Africa, Maibuye! There shall be peace and friendship, Africa, Maibuye! And so on.
Hey, go on, go on.
Now listen. When the police came in, armed with stem guns, someone started to sing Maibuye to the tune of Clementine.
Maibuye, 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 Africa.
You were all there. You, Walter, Nelson, and Oliver. It was so moving. The police took everything they could lay their hands on. Documents, banners, posters. When it got dark, they produced lamps. And while we were being searched, the band played freedom songs. And we all sang Nkosi Sikelele Africa. Walter, you could feel the promise of freedom. You could feel the promise of freedom in the air. I hope to see you soon, yours. Huh?
And we weren't there. There shall be peace and friendship.
Now you know why they banned us, so that we could not take part in our own history.
These freedoms we will fight for.
Hey.
Side by side,
throughout
our lives, until we have won our liberty. Africa, my Maibuye! I'm drunk. I'm terribly drunk. I'm drunk on the promise of freedom. We have started something that can't be stopped. The Freedom Charter will start a revolution.
And we weren't there.
Maibuye.
Maibuye, Maibuye, Africa. Maibuye, 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 Africa.
Maibuye, 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 Africa.
Nelson,
have you got a warrant to be in here?
Oh, man, I forgot. You're a lawyer. Boys, we got a gaffer lawyer here. Have I got a warrant? Yes, Nelson, I've got a warrant, and you're under arrest.
What's the charge?
Man, you got all the right questions. I'm going to tell you the charge, so listen carefully. The charge is high treason, Katha. High bloody treason.
I am making a further application for bail, my lord, because during the course of this trial, which, as your lordship well knows, has lasted many, many months. Of the 156 accused charged with high treason, 61 have had their indictment quashed. A further 65 were found not guilty. I therefore submit to your lordship that all 30 now remaining on trial should be put on bail immediately.
I'm inclined to agree. I shall grant bail to all the remaining accused.
Adelaide. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
Hello, Florence.
Oliver, I'm famished.
Okay, we'll find somewhere.
We could go to that cafe. You know the one I mean.
Anything you say, jump in.
Tigizero, I knew her father.
Winnie! Winnie! Do you want a lift?
Jump in. Winnie, I've seen you somewhere before.
She's been in the newspapers, Oliver. That's where you've seen her.
You've been in the newspapers?
I'm at the welfare clinic. I'm going to be a social worker. They came along and wanted photographs of some of us at work.
Well, well, well. In the newspapers, eh?
Give me some money, Oliver. Are you hungry, Winnie? I'm starving. I haven't eaten all day. Come on, Oliver, some money.
I left my wallet at the office. I haven't got a bean on.
Oliver!
What a moment. Luck is in. Look who's in the cafe. Go in, buy the whole shop, and tell Nelson he's got to pay for it. Emily!
I'm so pleased to see you. Oliver has got no money on him, but he says I can buy the whole shop as long as I make you pay.
How would you like? It's on me. Going to have to go back and wash the dishes.
We are supposed to be meeting in half an hour.
Make it an hour. Aren't you going to introduce me?
This is Nomzamo Winnie Madikizela, Nelson Mandela.
Would you believe it? Winnie and I come from the same village.
Are you related to this fellow?
Don't you know Winnie? She's always plastered all over the newspapers.
The welfare center, I remember. You're staying at the Helping Hand Hostel with Adelaide.
Okay, now, you've seen how we fold the nappy, step one, step two, and step three. Now, Angela, I'd like you to tell me and the students exactly what you feed your baby.
Well, I breastfeed my baby most of the time.
Is there a Winnie Madikizela here? Telephone call, important. Okay, Angela, carry on.
I breastfeed my baby most of the time. In the morning, I give him a pet
Yes, speaking. Who is it? Who? Oh, yes, pull the other one. Who is that? Come on, stop fooling around. I'm in the middle of a class. Who is it really? Oh. Yes? Sunday.
Yes.
What time? Yes. Okay.
Mr. Linder, one at a time.
Can
one
you tell me to move? Just tell me to move.
Sir, this is why I'm here. I swear it's the truth.
The mistress must have seen.
We just incommissionously talking, sir. And the policeman comes up my friend and tells him I can move along my friend's wife. And
you have my card also here.
Okay.
Mr. Mandela,
when can I call you Mr. Mandela?
You can call me anytime.
Nice day. How are you?
Okay.
I know it's urgent, and I'll see you after.
I
will speak for you. I'll be more than happy to speak for you.
Mr. Mandela, will you help my friend?
Yes, I will.
I saw you helping Mr. Mandela. It was unprovoked assault.
Can I come and see you?
I can imagine. Here's what. You call my office, speak to my partner, Oliver Temple.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
I'll call the office too, shall I?
Have you eaten Indian food before? Well, you're in for a treat. Just take a little bit, not too much. Now, here you go. Try this right here. This is really good. The potatoes are gone.
Mr. Mandela, sorry for the intrusion. You see, I've got a problem with my pass. It was stamped 100% correct. And this bastard.
Mr. Mandela, thank God you are here. They've just arrested my husband. The European hit him first, I swear to you.
Wait a moment, wait a minute.
Was he a first?
But my husband is under arrest. Okay. He's coming.
What is your name?
Mrs. Pumelo.
Mrs. Pumelo, I wish you'd call me tomorrow, okay? All right.
But he's coming before the magistrate tomorrow morning.
Mr. Mandela, I want to report to the police first thing tomorrow morning.
Mr. Mandela,
about the person. What should I do?
Mr. Mandela. I've been charged with indecent behavior in Willow Street. I wasn't drunk or anything.
It's my sister, just Mr. Mandela. It's my sister. She's been married to this man for 6 years. Now they want to reclassify him. I don't know what to do.
I want you to go and see my partner, Oliver Tambo. There's my card. You know how to... Oh, here.
Sorry.
It helps to take a little sip of water.
But, Mr. Mandela,
yes.
What about my pass? Oh, I'm 100% correct.
All right.
Mr. Mandela, can you be in court tomorrow morning? Yes. I don't even know what my husband was talking about.
Okay, Mr. Mandela, I'm going to admit it. Yeah. I had a few drinks, but I wasn't drinking in the street. I didn't swear nothing. Now, what's indecent behavior got to do with it?
Will you tell Mr. that I'll be phoning? I tried all day yesterday, and the phone was engaged.
Just come to my office. You know where it is. Just come and wait, and I'll see you all individually, okay?
Thank you, Mr. Mandela.
All right.
Honestly think that it would surrender?
Did I think what would surrender, my lord?
White supremacy. White supremacy.
I'm not sure I understand the question, my lord.
Oh, yes, you do. You understand it very well.
With due respect, my lord, can you put it to me again?
I want to know whether you considered that white supremacy in South Africa would, without a show of arms, surrender that which, if surrendered, would mean its end.
That was considered. It was... Yes. It was also considered that through our policy of exerting pressure, we would force the whites by using our numbers, our numerical preponderance, to grant us what we demand, even against their will.
And how would you use your numerical numbers to force white supremacy to give you what you want?
For example, by staying at home, not going to work, using our economic power for the purpose of attaining our demands. Telephone you. Why I wanted to see you. I wanted to ask you something really important. I'll come straight to the point. Will you help raise money for the defendants in the treason trial? I don't think anyone could resist you. The problems are enormous, of course. We're out on bail, but we haven't the time for that sort of thing. And there are lawyers to be paid, families to keep, and so on, so on. You understand? And the trial will go on for years and years. You'll help, won't you? I know you'll help. Are you cold? Did you hurt yourself?
No, it's just my shoe.
Think that the Defiance campaign had any effect at all on the government?
I think it had. After the Defiance campaign, the government began talking about self-government for Africans, Bantustans. I think they acted in order to deceive, but in spite of that deception, one thing comes out very clearly, and that is that they acknowledged the power of the Defiance campaign. They felt the power of the ANC had tremendously increased.
Well, as a matter of fact, isn't your freedom a direct threat to the Europeans?
No, it is not a direct threat to the Europeans. We are not anti-white. We are against white supremacy. We have consistently preached a policy of race harmony, and we have condemned racialism no matter by whom it is professed. I sent a friend to pick you up in a car.
I told him I'd rather walk.
Are you crazy? There are gangs about. I have enough troubles at the moment without worrying about you.
It's such a lovely evening, and I'm home now.
Just don't do it again.
I'm sorry.
By the way, you know that woman who's a dressmaker? I forget her name. You know who I mean. You must go and see her. She'll make you a wedding gown.
A what?
You can decide on how many bridesmaids you want.
This ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
With my worldly goods.
With my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Put it in. And now, will the congregation rise? Come, Zeko. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Since Nelson and Winnie have consented to live together in holy wedlock, I now pronounce them to be man and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen.
forgotten how beautiful the country is. It reminds me of where I was born. Terrible to be cooped up in the city. I need to see the sky and the green hills and the sun setting. I don't know what I'd do if they put me.
I know what I have been meaning to ask you. How much Lobola did you pay for me?
You cannot ask me, the son of a chief, a question like that.
Listen, you being royalty doesn't impress me.
It's between your father and myself. You know the custom. A bride must never find out how much Lobola was paid for her.
All I want to know is how much you think I'm worth. How many cattle did you get for me?
If I told you, you'd either be flattered or insulted. So I better shut up.
I'll find out, I'm telling you.
My God, I love you. Niakutanda. You see before you the happiest man in the world. If only we didn't have to go back.
Don't talk about it. We still have another couple of days.
I think I'm the only bridegroom who got married while out on bail.
I wonder what the future holds. I wonder what our life will be like.
We can't know, so there's no point in asking.
I know one thing. Life with you is life without you.
Don't say things like that. And anyway, you're wrong. And just to prove it, I'm going to take you with me on our honeymoon.
Honeymoon? What honeymoon? They gave us 4 days permission to get married. There is no time for a honeymoon.
You see, you're wrong again. And I'll tell you where we're going to spend that honeymoon. I'll be in the dock, and you'll be in the public gallery.
Not to pick up the people for work today. We're making a protest against the pass laws. So please stand back.
And if I refuse?
If you refuse, we're going to burn your pass. And that will make trouble for you. I hope we don't have to do that, eh?
Oh, well.
Today, we are going to protest against the pass laws. We meet at the police station.
Thank you. They're going to send somebody down to talk to you about the pass laws, okay?
Someone in authority, I hope.
Top brass.
Well, these people have been out.
I've got rid of him, sir. But I must tell you, I'm surrounded. They're smashing the fences. Yes. Yes. Must be about 20,000 of them. Oh, yes. They are hostile, all right. Sticks, stones. I would say I was under siege, sir. Okay, thanks. Someone in authority. Cheeky bastard.
Yeah.
going to have to be sooner than we thought.
Yes.
They're bound to ban us again.
That's for sure.
We may never see each other again.
Of course we'll see each other again. In Dar es Salaam, maybe. Or Accra.
Maybe. Seen me burn it. And as president of the African National Congress.
The African National Congress is bad.
I am urging others to do the same in protest against the murder of our people in Sharpeville.
You are under arrest.
The Sharpeville police were provoked by a communist-inspired mob. A state of emergency now exists throughout the country. And I have issued orders banning the African National Congress. Its leaders have already been imprisoned in Pretoria. The pass laws are to be reinforced, and we are outlawing all those whose aim it is to bring to its knees any white government in South Africa which stands for white supremacy and white leadership. They do not want peace. What they want is our country. We will not be altered in our course. We will not repeal one single law. We will not appoint a judicial commission of inquiry. We are not going to give in to communists.
Is the minister saying that anyone opposed to the government's racialist policy is a communist?
If the hat fits.
You tell them what we have to say. You tell them when we get out of here, we're going to fight. No more peaceful protests. We're going to get guns.
There's only one thing you are going to do, and that is take instructions from the executive committee.
What executive committee? The ANC is banned. Haven't you heard? They have detained 20,000 of us. 20,000, Mr. Sisulu. That's 20,000 soldiers. You tell them.
I'll say it once more. You will do nothing until the executive issues instructions.
There's only one instruction we need to hear. You tell them. Mr. Mandela, you have to make a decision. You can't go on talking for another 6 months, another year. You've been talking for too damn long. We have to fight now. You listen to me. We're not going to be pushed into this. We are leaders, elected leaders. And leaders are meant to lead. Otherwise, we have mob rule.
We say get guns, yes. Grenades, bombs, and hit them hard. Yeah.
That's all you know, is it? Guns, grenades, bombs. What else can we do?
What do you think we have been talking about all these months? We have been considering all the options.
Like what? Like sabotage, guerrilla warfare, urban warfare. Yes, even full-scale revolution.
Those are the four options.
And we say go as far as we can.
Yeah.
Armed revolution.
How do you think they will hit back? They will make something look like a Sunday school picnic.
We must avoid loss of life at all costs.
On both sides. Yes, on both sides.
We have to leave a little room for hope. Hope. You talk about hope. Here in this hall. You talk about hope. Hey, hey. You kill people and you kill hope.
Tell your friends. Soon we'll be making recommendations.
until such time.
Walter, I've been dreading this moment all my life.
It has to be faced.
Yes, I heard.
I'm still on trial for treason, so I'll have to go back into court. But when it's over, we'll be finding alternative methods of opposition.
I don't want to appear naive, but what's that mean?
We're not going to obey the decree banning the ANC. That's number one.
That would mean going underground.
Exactly. Chief, we have heard from Oliver in Dar es Salaam. The ANC in exile now exists. Oliver is beginning the job of enlisting support from all over the world. It will be a long, hard slog. In the meantime, I shall take care of ANC matters here as best I can.
And you, Nelson, what will you be doing? Chief. I'll report to you when the time is right.
The court will riot.
This long and complex trial is now coming to an end. It is almost 5 years since you were first brought before me. And I shall now give judgment. The prosecution has failed to prove that the ANC, as a matter of policy, intended to achieve a new society in South Africa by violent means. There is also no proof that it had become a communist organization or that it had been infiltrated by communists. You are found not guilty and discharged. You may go.
Girls, now just sit and don't mess yourselves up. Eh? Come. Again. Oh, God, I am so happy.
Oh, my darling, I meant to say. Just pack a few things for me in a suitcase.
Thank you.
country to Drew and Oliver?
No.
Then why am I packing these things?
Put these papers in for me, will you?
I didn't marry a man. I married a struggle.
Non-whites, a colonial power crawling on crutches out of the Middle Ages. Well, we will make one world, and we will bring them into a new age, whether they like it or not. And to the faint-hearted, I say this. Remember what our recent history has taught us. When they introduced apartheid in 1948, we called for demonstrations and strikes. And how did they respond? With more repressive legislation, with killing and maiming our people. We organized a defiance campaign. And what was their response? Our leaders were imprisoned and banned. When people were being forcibly removed from their land, we called for peaceful marches and meetings. And how did they respond?
by armed police enforcing the removal. We called the Congress of the People, and how did they respond? 156 people were charged with high treason. We called for one-day strikes and bus boycotts. We burned our passes. And how did they respond? By killing 69 men, women, and children at Sharpeville. I tell you, my brothers, my sisters, we have now the moral right to defend ourselves. Self-defense is a right. I shall fight the government side by side with you, inch by inch and mile by mile, and to victory as one. And what will you do? Will you come along with us or remain silent and neutral in this matter of life and death? For my own part, I have made my choice. I will not leave South Africa, nor will I surrender.
Makes a speech telling the people to defend themselves. Christ!
I know, sir.
Never mind about you bloody knowing, Swanepoel. What the hell are you going to do about it? You see what they're calling him? The Black Pimpernel. Making us a laughing stock.
I've got every available man looking for him, sir.
I'm not talking about looking for him, Swanepoel. I'm talking about bloody finding him.
We'll find him, sir.
You'd bloody better, Swanepoel, or you'll be back on the beat for life. I don't want any more of this Black Pimpernel stuff.
Mr. Franks?
Ah, how do you do? Come this way, it's number 3. Yeah, there is access to the garden.
Yeah, very nice.
It's a bachelor flat, of course. Yeah, this is the bedroom. Very good decorative condition.
Take it.
It's nicely furnished, and of course the bed's...
I said I'll take it. 10, 20, 30. Come on, David. Bring the bags. Over here. And hurry up, hey?
My name's Benny.
Mine's Nelson. You've been with us long.
Home sweet home, and I'm your nursemaid. What's the trouble?
Where do I sleep?
You sleep on the bed. I sleep
on this camp bed.
No. You sleep in the bed. I sleep on the camp bed.
Forgive me, but that's ridiculous. I'm 4 foot nothing. You're over 6 foot. It stands to reason. You have the bed. I have this.
Listen, Benny.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to be one of the leaders of this organization. So, you better learn to take orders.
Suddenly, I've lost faith in the leadership. I'm having the camp bed and no arguments.
Nelson, what the hell are you doing?
This is called running on the spot. Since I can't go out, I have to exercise somewhere.
Do you know what time it is? It's not yet 5.
I do this for 2 hours every day. You get used to it.
2 hours every day?
And you're going to join me.
No, thanks. I never do any exercise. I don't want to die young.
Come on, Billy. 2 hours every day, and that's another order. Come on. Come on.
Supposed to be a man of compassion.
You'll get used to it. You'll learn to love it.
What's that? You know your trouble. You've no sympathy for people more fortunate than yourself.
Come on, let's go.
I had a sergeant like you in the army. Up north in the desert. Tough. Really tough.
You see? Very pleasant this. We can talk, get to know each other.
Talk. I can hardly breathe.
Why didn't you join the movement, Benny? It always interests me. You could have had an easy life.
Did you believe for humanitarian purposes?
Yes, I believe that. Benny, I want you to do me a favor.
Listen, I'm not doing press-ups or anything like that.
No, no, something else.
Wazalapa.
Make yourself as beautiful as you can. An important personality wants to see you.
Thank you.
hours a day now.
Yes.
There's so little time to love you.
Shall I tell you what I do when I'm alone? I kiss your photograph. It seems to ease the longing for you.
I live for those times when someone comes and says, get ready, make yourself beautiful. And then they go and ruin my makeup with that blindfold. But when I know you're waiting for me, I can hardly breathe at the thought of seeing you. Want it any other way. I mean that.
Without you, without these moments, I would fall apart.
On the award of the Nobel Peace Prize to Chief Albert Luthuli. Chief Luthuli will soon be going to Oslo to receive the prize from the King of...
No problems?
No problems.
Hi, Nelson.
Have a moral right to defend ourselves.
And how will that be demonstrated?
My guess is the decision will be for sabotage. Government installations, symbolic targets, but not on any account loss of life.
You blow up a few buildings and you think that the government will surrender.
No, Chief. You know what we're aiming at.
You want to undermine confidence.
Of course, frighten our foreign capital, foreign investments.
Hit the pocket, and maybe also hit the heart.
Exactly.
Primitive, Nelson, but it'll work.
You've done a good job.
And you're still working on other devices? Yes, but this is the best so far.
Thank you.
to be quick. Just keep looking at the dresses. Don't say anything. You mustn't be sad at what I'm going to tell you. It may be a little while before I see you again. I have to go on a journey.
With the Prime Minister if we don't arrest that communist bastard. And I am threatening you with being back on the beat if we don't catch the bugger. Look at him! You see that other one with him? That's Oliver Tambo, head of the bloody ANC in exile. And you know where that picture's taken? In Addis bloody Ababa. And you know where that is? That's in bloody Ethiopia. And that means he's not talking to the Emperor Haile bloody Selassie, but to the terrorists! The bloody communist terrorists! This is Algeria. That's where the Reds were fighting the Frogs. The Reds won. So Mandela's not talking to the Frogs. And here he is in bloody London, talking to the Liberal Party and the Labour Party. And that means even more bloody communists. All we need now is to find him in America, talking to Bobby bloody Kennedy, and you have the whole bloody communist conspiracy! I want Mandela! He's getting arms and aid and talking to conferences and Christ knows what. Now you circulate his picture to every man on the force. And the moment he sets foot in this country again,
going, Nelson, and then turn right. It's called Lillisley Farm. There. It's a safe house. And when I say safe, I mean safe.
Gave himself up
because he wanted to end the slaughter. But do you know what the wicked spirits did? They put him in a prison on a rock at sea. A dark and evil fortress guarded by monsters. And they called that place Robin Island.
Shall I tell you something?
Yes, tell me.
You are in hiding. Onaran, the most wanted man in South Africa. And yet, this is the nearest to normal family life I have ever known.
Pause, please. Get the officer. Mandela's in the car.
Surround the car.
Get him out.
Lillian, I'm all home now.
Bye, Winnie.
Say love.
Tomorrow morning, I'm teaching at the antenatal clinic, so I'll be in late.
Yes. But we think he'll be appearing in the Johannesburg court tomorrow.
I think I just lost part of my soul.
Nelson Mandela, you have been found guilty on both counts. On the first count, that of inciting strikes, you are sentenced to 3 years imprisonment with hard labor. On the second count, that of leaving the country without valid travel documents, 2 years with hard labor.
Amanda! 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 Amanda!
Bloody lucky. If it was up to me, I'd have topped you. And Mandela, don't you worry. I'm going to tie you into terrorism. Oh, yeah, make no mistake. We'll get evidence.
I'd like to leave now, please.
Any case you want to confess? Start your sentence with a bit of solitary, just to collect your thoughts.
help you?
Oh, what? Extension 107, please.
One moment, please.
107, yes?
I will only speak to Lieutenant Swanepoel.
Swanepoel speaking.
Lily's Leaf Farm, Rivonia.
What? Say again?
If you want the ANC High Command, go to Lily's Leaf Farm at Rivonia.
Search from top to bottom.
Yes, sir.
Doors, cupboards, everything. Go on!
Albertina's fine. Winnie's fine, too. God. They're strong, man. They're strong.
First of all, Nelson, I don't know how much you know.
Brom, I know about Rivonia. I know they say they found evidence. They took great pleasure in telling me I was for the high jump. But what I don't know are the charges.
Nobody knows, but there have been leaks to the press.
Look. You can all be certain of one thing. You're all going to be charged with being involved in sabotage and guerrilla warfare.
We never decided on guerrilla warfare. On the contrary, our policy was not to endanger human life.
Okay. But as sure as you're sitting there, they're going to say you wanted to bring down the government by violent revolution.
And in your case, Nelson, I'm sure they're going to say that your trip abroad was to raise funds for the struggle.
Yes. And of course, communism is bound to come into it somewhere. There's no point trying to bluff ourselves. Whatever the charges, they're going to carry the death penalty. The government wants a hanging. We've got a hell of a fight on our hands. What I suggest is we attack each charge in detail. My information is there may be as many as 200 separate allegations of sabotage.
Obviously, I haven't had a chance to discuss this with the others. But I'll tell you what I feel. I think we have a wonderful opportunity here. I don't think we should fight them on legal grounds.
Nelson, we're talking about the death penalty. We must defend you on legal grounds.
No. If they want to hang us, they'll hang us. So let's make the best of it. We have to turn this into a political trial.
We have also been talking about this, Brahm. And I think I can say that we are 100% behind Nelson. This is a chance to use the court as a platform to make known what we believe in. And we will be talking to the whole world.
Right.
We can defy the government in open court. We can speak with pride.
We can explain why we were driven to do what we did. We've got nothing to be ashamed of. We had no alternative. That's what I want to say.
And I think we should go further. We should say that we want to bring the government down and tell them why.
Agreed. I think we should say, Yes, we took part in Axis sabotage. Yes, I went abroad to get help for the struggle. Our only defense is attack. It's no good fighting them in law. We have to fight them politically, not on their terms, but on ours. You realize that's like putting the noose around your own necks. That without violence, there would be no way open to the African people to succeed in their struggle against the principle of white supremacy. All lawful modes of expressing opposition to this principle had been closed by legislation, and we were placed in a position in which we had either to accept the permanent state of inferiority or to defy the government. We chose to defy the law. Another of the allegations made by the state is that the aims and objects of the ANC and the Communist Party are the same. I wish to deal with this. It is true that there has often been close cooperation between the ANC and the Communist Party, but cooperation is merely proof of a common goal, in this case, the removal of white supremacy. The history of the world is full of similar examples. Perhaps the most striking example is to be found in the cooperation between Great Britain, the United States of America, and the Soviet Union in the fight against Hitler. Nobody but Hitler would have dared to suggest that such cooperation turned Churchill or Roosevelt into communists, or that Britain and America were working to bring about a communist world. I have never been a member of the Communist Party. Communists regard the parliamentary systems of the West as being undemocratic and reactionary. But on the contrary, I'm an admirer of such a system. I have great respect for British political institutions. I regard the British Parliament as the most democratic institution in the world. The American Congress, that country's doctrine of separation of power, as well as the independence of the judiciary, arouse in me similar sentiments. During my lifetime, I have dedicated myself to this struggle of the African people. I have fought against white domination, and I have fought against black domination. I have cherished the ideal of a democratic and free society in which all persons live together in harmony and with equal opportunities. It is an ideal which I hope to live for and to achieve, but if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
The crime of which the accused have been convicted is, in essence, one of high treason. The state has decided not to charge the crime in this form. Bearing this in mind and giving the matter very serious consideration, I have decided not to impose the supreme penalty. Consistent with my duty, this is the only leniency I can show. The sentence in the case of all the accused will be one of life imprisonment.
Mrs. Winnie Mandela, who was banned for 5 years to Orlando Township near Johannesburg, has had additional restrictions imposed on her by the South African government. Mrs. Mandela is the wife of the imprisoned South African leader, Nelson Mandela. These restrictions prevent her from writing or publishing articles and books. Her husband is serving a life sentence on Robben Island.
Mrs. Winnie Mandela, the wife of the imprisoned black South African leader Nelson Mandela, is becoming an increasingly important political figure in her own right. Although banned by the government and prevented from speaking publicly, she is, according to reliable sources, active in keeping alive her husband's name. And in her work with young people, she is frequently charged with violating her banning order. She is allowed 2 visits a year to her husband.
Mrs. Mandela, you can come now. But I must remind you to talk about your family and the children. That's all.
I know. I have been coming here for almost 5 years.
Don't be cheeky. You mustn't say anything that's political. And if there's something in your conversation that we doesn't understand, we shall cut your visit.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Who is Nikki?
She's my sister. She's been ill.
Okay.
Nikki's getting better. Send love.
Kiss them for me.
I am in solitary confinement. I keep myself sane by composing letters in my mind to you. This is my 3rd month. I am well. You mustn't worry about me. I live for the day when we will be together again. The children are being looked after by our loving friends and family. I am well. You mustn't worry about me.
Although I always try to put on a brave face, I never get used to you being in the cooler. Few things disorganize my whole life as much as this particular kind of hardship. But I know your spirit cannot be broken, my darling mom. even after how long is it? Nearly a year in that dreadful place. I paused here and drank some coffee, after which I dusted the photographs on my bookcase. I started with that of Zini, then lastly yours, my darling mom. I dusted carefully every morning, for to do so gives me the pleasant feeling that I am caressing you as in the old days. I even touch your nose with mine to capture the electric current that used to flush through my blood whenever I do so.
This is my 14th month in solitary confinement. I write to you in my mind every day. I am fine. The children are fine. Don't worry about us. I love you. I long for you. I think this is my 14th month.
How does Danbo get his instructions to you? Who is the go-between? Come on, come on! You've got a lot to tell me.
Major. You haven't let me sleep. I don't know how long. My hands and feet are blue and swollen. I'm ill.
For God's sake, leave me some inheritance if you're going to pop it. You can't go with all that information.
I keep myself sane by looking for ants, any living thing. By holding conversations with the children, who are not here, and by writing these letters in my mind. I have been so hardened by this experience that at the end of my interrogation, if my own father walked in dangling a gun and he was on the other side, then if I had a gun too, in defense of the ideals for which I was being tortured, I would fire.
When I am released, and if on my return I found you away from home, I'd seek you out and report to you first. For that honor is yours and yours alone. How long is it since I've seen you, darling mom? 1 year and 4 months, I think. One half-hour visit and one letter every 6 months is a cruel and degrading ration. Yet I live for your letters and your visits. The last time, you had lost a bit of weight. Nonetheless, you looked well and highly seductive with your earrings hanging down to your breasts. I wanted to kiss the glass partition at the end of that visit. I love you. I love you, my darling mom.
I am beginning my 17th month in solitary. I keep myself sane by writing these letters. I am well. The children are being looked after. You mustn't worry about me. I love you. I wish I could get letters from you. Just one would reconstruct my shattered soul and restore it to my faith. I have no news. I am well. The children are well.
Winnie's out.
Thank God.
17 months in solitary, and then they go and renew her banning order for another 5 years. They've given her house arrest at nights and at weekends. She's not allowed visitors. But the word is, she's well, and the children are well.
Now that's the best news we've had in a long time.
But I worry about her, Walter. You know how she is. She won't keep quiet for long. She'll be in trouble again.
She's strong. They are stronger than we are, Nelson.
Yes. They're stronger than we are. I'm happy today. And I'm really feeling confident for the future.
And the life, says the Lord, he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. Praise ye the Lord. Man that is born of a woman hath but a short time to live, and is full of misery. He that cometh up and is cut down like a flower, he fleeth as it were a shadow, and never continueth. In one day, in the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom may we seek for succor, but of the Lord, the maker and the creator of everything. May his name be praised. He is the giver and he takes. Thank be to God. He knows everything. He understands our suffering. He will not leave us alone. His name may be praised.
Yeah. Never mind the suitcase. We're packing the lot. You're under arrest.
What do you mean you're packing the lot? Get out of here!
Don't make any trouble. Just do as you're told. Go and get dressed.
No! What do you think you're doing? All of you go now! Stop it! Get out of here! Stop this! Don't touch these. Don't touch these.
You are being banished to Brandfolk in the Orange Free State.
Lutzek! Get out of my house, all
come
of you!
On,
you
come
have no right here!
You'll be informed of your rights!
You are prohibited from attending within the Republic of South Africa any gathering. Any social gathering, being within any Bantu area. You are prohibited from performing any of the following acts: preparing, compiling, printing, publishing, disseminating, or transmitting in any manner whatsoever any publications, communicating in any manner whatsoever with any person whose name appears on any list in the custody of the officers. Receiving at the said residential premises any visitor other than a medical practitioner, your children, Zanani and this one.
Quick! Quick! This is not a holiday
resort! Don't! Don't!
Quick!
Get your head off me!
Cut!
Don't touch me!
Cut! Move!
Pick these up!
And the children?
They are fine.
Stand back a little.
What?
Stand back a little. Go on. Stand back. Let me see you.
Reports from South Africa indicate that the imprisoned black South African leader, Nelson Mandela, has been moved from Robben Island, where he has been serving a life sentence. He is to continue to serve that sentence on the mainland at Paulsmoor, a high-security prison near Cape Town.
This way, please.
It is not known whether the conditions of his imprisonment will be relaxed. His wife, Mrs. Winnie Mandela, who has been banished to Brandfort in the Orange Free State, has been allowed only strictly regulated visits and has had no physical contact with her husband since he began his sentence 22 years ago.
In here, please.
Why have they brought us in here? He must be ill.
No, Mummy. We would have heard.
They have never shown me in here before.
Mrs. Mandela, you're allowed contact visits from now on.
Protests against the life imprisonment of Mr. Nelson Mandela, the black South African leader, have been made in several countries in recent weeks. Marches in Washington, London, and other European capitals have been calling for Mr. Mandela's release. As the pressure builds, sources close to the South African government believe that the state president, Mr. P.W. Botha, will shortly be making a statement.
The government is willing to consider Mr. Mandela's release on condition that Mr. Mandela gives a commitment that he will not make himself guilty of planning, instigating, or committing acts of violence for the furtherance of political objectives. The choice is his.
Have you made up your mind yet?
You'd be a fool not to accept the state president's offer and get the hell out of here, Mr. Mandela. Nobody expects you to do more than you've already done. A third of your life in prison. Nobody will blame you if you grab your freedom now. You've done all that a man can do. You should go now. Go. Live with your wife, with your children and grandchildren. You're entitled to that, aren't you?
A South African government spokesman said today that no reply to President P.W. Botha's offer has yet been received from Nelson Mandela, the imprisoned ANC leader. Our Southern Africa correspondent reports that Mrs. Winnie Mandela, together with her lawyer, is due to meet her husband any day now, and she is expected to make Mr. Mandela's response public. The visit will take place in Paulsmoor, the maximum security prison near Cape Town. Mr. Mandela has served 24 years of his life sentence.
Your freedom and mine cannot be separated. I will return.